Good morning, everybody. Welcome to our live coverage of the PWBA Minnesota Open. First round of match play getting started here this morning. Round robin match play. 8 games in the first round, 8 games in the second round. Opening matches, Danielle McEwen against Diana Zavialova and Brianna Caldwell against Stephanie Johnson. So standard PWBA Tour format again this week. It is 16 games of round robin match play today. All the pins from yesterday carry forward. And at the end of the 16 games today, based on the 28 game totals, we'll have our top four for the stepladder tonight at 6:30 p.m. Central here on Bull TV on Extra Frame. Shannon Pluhowski is the leader after qualifying at plus 541, a 245 average. And you have Missy Parkin at plus 431, Rocio Restrepo at plus 414. And Sandy Gongora rounds out the top four at plus 379 after 12 games. Danielle McEwen at plus 367, Brianna Caldwell at plus 352. Kayla Bandy plus 311, Jackie Carbonetto plus 308. Kelly Kulick at plus 291, Jody Wessner plus 276, Stephanie Johnson plus 256, Diana Zavialova plus 252, Christina Wendell plus 244, Liz Johnson at plus 240, Megan Kelly plus 207, and Lindsay Boomershein, the last player to get in at plus 197. Lindsay defeated Clara Guerrero in a roll-off last night for the last spot in the cut. Boomershein defeating Guerrero 246 to 234 to advance into match play today. Stephanie Johnson off to a hot start with the front three. Let's see if Diana can do the same in her match. She does. 30 bonus fins for each win, so each game very important. Thank you. Diana's got the front four, as does Stephanie. We had some good scores in qualifying. Very well. Might have some big scores here in match play this week as well. Double for McEwen cuts into the deficit a little bit, but she's down big early in the match. Diana up by 32 currently after 4.5 frames. Another strike for Diana, front five. And Stephanie also takes it to the front five. Striking along here. Comes up a little light. Still gets the carry. Front six. See if Stephanie can match it now, as we've got a pretty quick start to the morning. You can see they're both playing kind of different parts of the lane. Stephanie that time leaves the 2-8. Stephanie much more right than Diana is in her match. And looked like she leaked that one a little bit right, leaves the 10 pin. Spare's good for Stephanie. She leads by about 50. 30. And Danielle falling more and more behind here as this game progresses. Another strike for Diana. Front seven. Mm-hmm. Caldwell with a 10-pin looking a little frustrated this morning. Five single-pin leaves and seven frames certainly will leave you a bit frustrated. Another strike for Diana. You can see how far left she is. She's even off the screen a little bit. Playing pretty far left on the fresh this morning on a 47-foot pattern. Low volume, but it is the longest distance pattern we have seen so far this season. It's pretty much the Paris pattern. If you'd like to see the actual graph, you can go to PWBA.com, click on Tournaments and Details for the PWBA Minnesota Open. Stephanie with another single pin, or another spare attempt coming up here at least. Still up by 31. Danielle whiffs at the 4-9 for the Open. And that locks up the win for Diana for sure. Stephanie leaves the four. A lot of hold room there on that shot. Stephanie misses the spare. Don't see that too often. Diana trying to keep it perfect, and she does. Front nine for Saviello. Give you a little bit closer look here at Diana, who has the front nine. She steps up here, looking to take it to the front 10. Oh, stone nine ends the run for Diana. So a great start to the day for Diana, but a brutal nine pin ends the run at perfection. But something to get us going this morning. Maybe we'll have another crack at one here on our Bull TV on extra frame pairs throughout the day today. This week did find a way to score pretty high, so not out of the realm of possibility that we could see some big numbers today. Shannon Pluhowski's 245 average in qualifying yesterday was the highest qualifying average of the season so far. Stephanie gets the double. She had a little work to do after missing that single pin in the eighth. She'll need one more to shut out Caldwell. Stephanie goes 9 spare here. She's at 234. Caldwell can strike out for 236. So Brianna just hoping for a little bit of light here at the end of the tunnel to try to steal this game. Stephanie trying to slam the door shut. It's a great shot. Big double in the 10th for Stephanie Johnson to pick up the 30 bonus pins. Place to leave that one. 4-9 split on the fill, 243 for Stephanie Johnson. Diana Zavialova, 279. Danielle McEwen, 181. So almost a 100-pin victory for Diana in game one. Thank you. All right, getting started. Game two, Kelly Kulick against Kayla Bandy. Jody Westner against Brianna Caldwell. Just joining us, we're live at Island Extreme Bowl, Welch, Minnesota, for the PWBA Minnesota Open. This is game two in round one of match play this morning. Caldwell trying to rebound after the split, leaves the seven pin. So Caldwell trailing early against Westner. Bandy with a mark lead on Kulick as well. Thank you. Caleb Andy looking for a double. Ends up leaving the four pin. She still leads by 12. We are about 3.5 frames into this match, game number two. Caldwell with the strike down by 21. Pin lead for Bandy. Wessner trying to clean up the mess here. Picks up the spare in the fourth. She leads by 18 after four frames here in game two of eight, first round of match play at the PWBA Minnesota Open. Double by Kayla pushes her lead up to 22. Kelly just can't seem to get much going here in this second game this morning. I have an update for you on the standings. Looks like Shannon Plahowski shot 215 and 1, plus 586 now for Plahowski. Missy Parkin, 275 out of the gates this morning, with a victory. And plus 536, so she's now just 50 back of Pluhowski. Rocio Restrepo, now in third place at plus 448. Sandy Gongora is fourth at plus 396. Kayla Bandy in fifth at plus 378. Shot 237 her first game and won. Brianna Caldwell is 29 pins back of fourth. Diana Zavialova 35 back, so that 279 really helped her quite a bit. Moved her up quite a bit in the standings. Kelly Kulik 40 off the show. Danielle McEwen 48. Liz Johnson 57. Jackie Carbonetto 66. Stephanie Johnson 67 pins off the show right now. Christina Wendell 85 pins off. Jody Westner 127, Megan Kelly 157, and Lindsay Boomershine 192. So really at this stage, every single player still has a chance to make it into the top four based on their performance here in these last 15 games. Round robin match play to close out their totals to determine the stepladder finalists. Nobody shut out yet. Kelly covers up the spare. Shooting a lot of spares this game, not a whole lot of strikes. Caldwell working on a double. Trying to hang in there with Westner. There's another strike. So Caldwell down by 18. Three frames to go here, game two. Bandy with the messenger that misses in front of the 10. Jody Westner can really take complete control of this match with a couple of more strikes. Meanwhile, Kayla Bandy up by 24 on Kelly Kulik with three frames to go. Here's Kulik, eighth frame, needs to get something going if she wants to win this game. Gets a strike finally, only her third strike in eight frames. Missed opportunity for Westner there to really put some distance between herself and Caldwell, but she still leads by 18 pins with two to go. Kelly unable to get the double, leaves the 10 pin. Look at the 7 pin Did a little dance for Wessner there before finally falling for the strike in the ninth. Caleb Bandy in pretty good control here against Kelly Kulik. Kelly can only shoot 195. And even with an open here, Caleb would be in the 200s. Goes a little high on that one. Almost leaves the nine. Gets a strike with three in a row, and Kayla Bandy on her way to a big game here. It'll be 239 with victory, pushing her to plus 69. She's currently in fifth place. Depending on how Gagora is doing this game, she could move up. Looks like Sandra shot 217 and lost. So it seems like Kayla Bandy could move into the top four after this game. Spot for a 7-10 split, 37 for Kayla Bandy. Trip four for Kelly. So, a couple of blowout wins here in game two on our featured pairs. Jody Wessner are going to be in the 240s. Pick up the easy win against Caldwell. Kayla Bandy picks up the easy win against Kelly Kulik. Getting started with game three, we've got Lindsay Boomersheim against Rocio Restrepo and Megan Kelly versus Sandra Gongora. Here for game three of eight in our match play at the PWBA Minnesota Open. Gongora with a strike in the third, but trailing by 20 early here against Megan Kelly. Meanwhile, Lindsay Boomersheim, who made the cut based on a win in a roll-off against Clara Guerrero last night. And we're all tied up in that match after two frames. Update on the standings for you. Shannon Plahowski 2-0 so far today at plus 643 as her lead expands thanks to Missy Parkin losing with 198 game, it looks like. So Plahowski at plus 643, Missy Parkin at plus 534. Rocio Restrepo right behind Missy at plus 522. Kayla Bandy, as we expected, moved up to fourth at plus 445. So your top four right now, Plahowski, Parkin, Restrepo, and Bandy. Fifth place is Diana Zavialova, 19 pins back. Sandy Gongora at 22 pins back of fourth. Danielle McEwen, 30 back. Liz Johnson, 41. Brianna Caldwell, 72. Kelly Kulik, 95 pins back. Stephanie Johnson, 100 back. Jody Westner, 102 back. Jackie Carbonetto, 105. Christina Wendell, 113. Lindsay Boomersheim, 135. And Megan Kelly, who's up right now on the right side of your screen, 201 pins off the show currently. But Megan coming on strong here. Game three with the front four. Megan is 0-2 in her matches today. Everybody today, plus 21 or better, not plus 18 or better for the first two games. Talking about actual scratch score. High scratch score so far this morning is plus 114 for the first two games, 514 for Diana Zavialova. Liz Johnson close behind at 504 for her first two games. So Liz and Diana averaging over 250 for the first two games today. Gora with another single pin on that left lane. Three single pins in a row on the left lane for Gora. Megan Kelly trying to keep it perfect, and she does. Packs all 10 back for the front six. But Megan Kelly can put up a big game here, maybe 270. And a win really helps her a lot. She's down in 16th place currently, but only 201 pins behind fourth, so she could cut that in half maybe in one game. Restrepo with the 10 pin, trailing by 11 against Boomershein. Megan Kelly trying to keep it going, and she does. Front seven for Megan Kelly, who, by the way, bowled 288 in her last game yesterday to make the cut. She was well below the number going into the last game, but had a spare in the first frame and then threw a whole bunch of strikes until the fill ball to shoot 288 to make the cut. Thank you. Boomershine up by 11. But that one got away from her a little bit. Leaves the washout with the sleeper back there. 1-2-8-10 on the spare, by the way. So that cuts her lead to 7. Nagora losing this game, but trying to get as many pins as she can. She can still shoot 229. May not be enough to win this game. It still could be, but... And now trailing big against Megan Kelly, who's got the front 7. Boomershine has to make this to maintain her lead. Otherwise, Restrepo will take the lead for the first time in this match. Got chance. And, oh, wraps the head pin around the 10 for the open. Now Restrepo leads by 4. Megan Kelly, front 7, trying to take it to 8. A little high. Oh, a little lucky break on that 4 pin for the front 8. Wow. Had a pin coming across from the other direction. Take out that 4 for her. Megan's got the front 8 now. All right, here's Megan. That one looks a little right. Yeah, it was. Somehow the 2 falls for the strike in the front 9. That is about the luckiest 2 frames you'll see right there on the front 7. As she takes it to the front 9 with a couple of lucky breaks. Strepo with the double, taking full advantage of the back-to-back opens by Boomershine, who looks to be making a ball change here. Rocio rings the 10. Up by 24 now, her lead swelled thanks to the double and the opens by Boomershine. Be at 208 with a strike. And she finishes out this game. She's unable to keep up with the striking power of Megan Kelly. Here's a strike for Lindsay Boomershine in the 8th. She recovers after a couple of open frames. We will go over now to Megan Kelly, who has the front 9. Second time today we've reached the front 9. Number 10 is good. So Megan Kelly just a couple of strikes away here. Again, another strike, front 11. Megan Kelly on the approach, a chance for a 300 game here in match play at the PWBA Minnesota Open. Goes high and leaves the four pin. 299 for Megan Kelly. Great game. It's going to help her cause a lot as she is trying to move up the standings from the basement, 16th place. Restrepo up by 23 with the spare here in the ninth. She'll need good count on her first shot in the 10th to lock up the win against Boomershein. Bye. Well, congratulations to Christina Wendell, who just shot 300, and she's coming over to our featured pairs right now to bowl Shannon Pluhowski. Shot 300 at Missy Parkin that game. So I got there just in time, got a video. We'll put that on our PWBA Facebook page, so you guys can see that final shot. So we're underway with our fourth game here at the PWBA Minnesota Open Match Play. Sandra Gongora against Liz Johnson and Shannon Pluhowski against Christina Wendell. Wendell fresh off a 300 game in game three. As soon as we have an update for you on the standings, we will let you know. Thank you. Should have an update on the standings for you here momentarily, if not already. Let's take a look. Yep, we do have an update. Shannon Pluhowski plus 635 in the lead. Rocio Restrepo has moved up to second at plus 567. Kayla Bandy plus 523. Missy Parkin now in fourth at plus 508. Christina Wendell at 300. Moved her up considerably. It's a plus 462, 46 pins back of the show. Danielle McEwen is 57 back. Liz Johnson, 58. Diana Zafialova, 67. Sandra Gongora at 77 back. Jody Westner and Stephanie Johnson, both 87 pins behind fourth. Kelly Kulick, 103. Brianna Caldwell, 128. Jackie Carbonetto, 134. And Megan Kelly, with her 299, only moves up one spot from 16th to 15th, but instead of being more than 200 pins behind fourth place, now Megan is only 135 pins back of fourth. So she really took a huge chunk out of that in one game. And then Lindsay Boomershine is in 16th, 196 pins back of fourth. Got Liz Johnson with the front four of this game on our featured pairs. We had Christina Wendell just shoot the 300 game. Finalizing posting that right now. Should be just a couple of minutes and it will be posted on our PWBA Facebook page, facebook.com/PWBA Tour, as Sandy Gongora leaves the uncommon 4-7-9-10. You'll see it every once in a blue moon, but it's not too often you see three pins in the back row still standing after a shot. It's a very makeable split, though. If you could basically make the 4-9, you got a good chance of making the rest of them. And look at that. Sandy Gongora cleans it up. 4-7-9-10 split conversion. Gore trying to start a string of strikes here, working on one strike, turn it into a double, and leaves the 10 pin. Trails pretty big here against Liz Johnson. 20 pin deficit for Gore. Could have been a lot more, but Liz had that split in the sixth to help keep things a little bit closer. Plachowski is taking it to Christina Wendell this game. Christina fresh off her 300 game, which we just posted on our Facebook and Twitter accounts, if you'd like to check that out. It was a huge game for Wendell to move her up the standings. She's at 758 now for her first three games today. Scratch, 2-1 in her matches. Went on plus 130 in one game. So for example, if Christina would have shot 200 and lost that game, she'd be at plus 332, which would be in 15th place. Instead, she's in 5th. But she's kind of going the wrong direction this game. Shannon Pulowski with a break there on the 7 pin for a 5 bagger. Looks like Rocio Restrepo has the front 8 on the same pair that Christina Wendell just shot 300 on. Rocio just left a single pin in the 9th, so her run of strikes comes to an end at 8. Thank you. as Johnson leaves the single pin. This match getting very interesting. She only leads by 10 now. Heading into the 10th frame. Wendell trying to kind of regroup here after getting excited over that 300. Only going to max at 194 this game, and she's going to lose to Pluhowski. Liz Johnson can strike out for 234. That is exactly the score that Sandra Mingora can shoot. Liz gets the first one as the seven pin falls backward for the strike. Johnson leaves the 10. That's going to open the door for Gagora to win this game. She will need a double in the 10th, however. Pluhowski could still shoot 249 this game. Sandy gets the first one. She's going to need one more. Pluhowski strikes out for 249. Big shot here for Sandy Gongora. Gongora's been going the wrong direction all day. Gets the strike, and she's going to pick up her first win of the day here in match play. She was 0-3 before this match. So Gagora finally going to get on the board with a win and pick up some bonus pins. .232 to .224. Gongora picks up the win. And we will head into game five here. Stephanie Johnson against Missy Parkin. 15 and 16, 17 and 18. Looks like it's going to be Rocio Restrepo against Jody Wessner. Missy Parkin, perfect so far. 3 for 3. Stephanie Johnson trying to keep it perfect. Kind of a shootout here early on against Missy Parkin in game 5. Another strike. Right after 16 games, standings are updated. Shannon Puchowski still in the lead at plus 714. Behind her, you've got Rocio Restrepo at plus 653. Kayla Bandy is at plus 621. And Missy Parkin at plus 596. Jody Westner now 88 pins off the show. Things have really kind of stretched out a little bit in the standings. Things were very close a couple of games ago, but things starting to stretch out just a bit as Jody Westner now 88 pins off the show. Zavialova 89 pins back. Gongora 103, Kulik 108, McEwen 115. Stephanie Johnson 116, Liz Johnson 122. Wendell 141, Caldwell 189, Carbonetto 218, Kelly 224, and Boomershine 254 pins off the show currently. With 12 games to be added to the standings, Smissy Parkin steps up with the front four. She gets the hit to carry for the front five. Nine shots thrown, nine strikes on the board between the two players in this match. If you like strikes, you've come to the right place because we have got a lot of striking going on right now on 15 and 16. Let's see if Missy can keep up with Stephanie here. It's in. And she got that in 4-7-9 split for Missy Parkin. Could tell off her hand that that was left. Give it a run here. Gets two though. Open frame for Parkin. Stephanie Johnson now has the upper hand in this match. Jody Westner, she misses the 2-8 in the fourth. Allows Rocío Restrepo to take a 13-pin lead. Oh. see if Stephanie Johnson can take it to the front seven. Oh, Stephanie looking pretty lined up here in game five. Rocio with a double, pushes her lead to 23. Stephanie up, eighth frame, perfect so far. She stays that way, 8-8. Jody Wessner with a double, cuts it back to 13. Parkin gets a double. She can still shoot 255 this game. So that strike right there actually keeps her mathematically in it here, depending on how Stephanie Johnson finishes. Missy could still win this game. Another strike for Rowe. And here is Steph. To hook a little bit, leaves the 10, ends the string at 8. And as long as she stays clean with good count, she will win this game. Another strike for Restrepo. Four in a row for Rocio. Restrepo leads by 33. 3.5 frames to go. That'll lock up the win for Stephanie. J. Johnson trying to now get to 279 this game. Get her plus 109, really help her cause. That would move her up to plus 589. Should move her up a couple of spots in the standings for sure. Great game by Stephanie Johnson, 278. Trying to get as many pins as she can here to minimize the damage of losing. 255 would be a great game if she can strike out. She really only had one real bad shot this game. She just missed a little left and left the 479 in the sixth. Otherwise, she'd be virtually even with Stephanie in this game. Rocio just missed the 10 pin. She still leads by 21 though. .278, .255. Stephanie Johnson wins the high-scoring game against Missy Parkin. Restrepo can still strike out for .227. Jody Westner can strike out for .226. Well, it could be a pretty good finish here to this game. Westner with the strike, pulls to within 11. A six count. 2-4-5-7 for Wessner. Lowers the likelihood that she will win this game by a significant margin. Picks it up. It's only going to be a 2-0-2. Rocio just needs a few pins count here. Sissy, actually Rocio needs 8 pins to guarantee the win. 8 pins on her first ball. If she gets less than 8, she can still win if she makes the spare. We're going to have Christina Wendell against Kayla Bandy here momentarily on 15 and 16 for game 6. And that is strike is the best way to guarantee the win. Rocio will take the win here. This game could strike out still for 227. Get her to plus 57 for the game with the bonus pins. That would put her at plus 710. Looks like Boomershine against Carbonetto coming up on 17 and 18. Lindsay starts with a strike. Carbonetto comes up light, and that pin almost fell over. leaves the seven standing. Shine with the double to start this game. Leads by 10. Caleb Andy trailing by 9. Should have an update on the standings for you here in just a second. It looks like they are updated now. Shannon Plahowski plus 739. Rocio Restrepo in second at plus 700. Caleb Andy with a strike there for the double. She's in third, plus 665. Missy Parkin in fourth at plus 651. Diana Zavialova plus 595. Stephanie Johnson plus 588. So Diana's 56 back. Stephanie 63 back of fourth. Danielle McEwen is 92 pins back. Kelly Kulick 97 pins back. And then a big jump down to Jody Westner, 141 back of fourth. Sandra Gregor 142. Everybody else more than 150 back of fourth place. Kayla, a little high on that shot. Lucky to get the four out, leaves just the 9. And she leads by 1 pin with the spare. Just a couple of more games to go after this one to wrap up round one of match play here at the PWBA Minnesota Open. But we've got another 8-game round coming up this afternoon at 1:30 p.m. Central Time. Thank you. Boomershine comes up light to a 10 in the fourth. And unless she can find a way to spare it, she will trail for the first time in this game. Kayla Bandy looking for her third consecutive strike, gets the hit, the carry. And she is up by, let's see here, 21 pins on Christina Wendell. Lindsay Boomershine with the double. She trails by 4. Shot by Boomershine, doesn't get the carry, leaves the 7. Got a chance to take the lead with a strike there. Carbonetto working on a double, trying to build on her lead. Another strike for Carbonetto, four in a row. Kayla Bandy with the spare in the ninth, so going into the tenth, she's up by 21. Lindsay Boomershine trying her best to put some pressure on Carbonetto here if she can throw a strike. She does for the double. So Lindsay can strike out for 233. Jackie Carbonetto can strike out for 258. Strike will lock up the win for Kayla Bandy. Carbonetto with another strike, five in a row. She needs a spare with good count to lock up the win here against Boomershine. Carbonetto needed a mark with good count instead. She leaves the split. 4-6-7 split. Good finish by Kayla Bandy getting the double in the 10th. She shoots 237 to pick up the win against Christina Wendell. 223 for Carbonetto. So Lindsay Boomershine will need a double in the 10th to win this game. First one, Boomershine one strike away from the win here in game six. gets the double, and Lindsay Boomershine comes from behind to win this game against Carbonetto. Just needs to keep it on the lane. One pin is all Boomershine needs to take the win. Carbonetto will stay defeated on the day. She's not won a match. She'll move to 0-6. .233-223. Boomershine defeats Carbonetto. So we've got Megan Kelly against Jackie Carbonetto and Liz Johnson versus Danielle McEwen here for Game 7. And if you're wondering why Carbonetto is wearing a hoodie, it's very, very cold here in this bowling center. I don't know what the temperature is in here, but it's got to be in the 60s. It's very cold in this bowling center, and so they've allowed some of the players to wear long sleeve attire if they need to. Most of the players are putting on a jacket when they come back off the approach. So Liz Johnson steps up second frame against Danielle McEwen. Matches on the low end, just finishing. So it'll be a minute or two before we get the updated standings. even though we're already in the second, third frame here of this game on our feature pairs. They are the first pairs to get started pretty much with game seven. Frame for Megan Kelly after starting with a double. Danielle and Liz both perfect still after three frames. As Danielle steps up here at fourth frame and rings a 10 pin. Carbonetto up by four. A little high on that shot, leaves the four pin. Could have been a little worse, but only the four is left. As Johnson makes her four pin. They are all tied up in that one after four frames. Strike for McEwen as she takes a one-pin lead on Johnson. Half the game to go. update for you after 18 games, and we have a new leader. Rocio Restrepo takes the lead in the tournament at plus 777. Shannon Pluhowski at plus 743. Kayla Bandy at plus 732. And Missy Parkin rounds out the top four at plus 666. Stephanie Johnson, 21 pins off the show currently. Danielle McEwen, 33 pins back. Diana Zavialova, 84 back. Kelly Kulik, 86. Jody Westner, 88. Sandra Gongora, 92 off the show. Everybody else, 169 pins back or more. Carbonetto with a double, leads by 13. Megan Kelly misses the spare. Jackie Carbonetto, our lead increases by a mark, sitting on the bench. Looks like Jackie's warmed up a bit. She's taking her hoodie off. McEwen working on a strike, up by three, and turns it into a 13-pin lead. More game to go in this round, and then we will have a break until 1:30 Central Time, when we will start the final eight games of round robin match play here at the PWBA Minnesota Open. McEwen in control so far in this match against Liz Johnson. Mainly because Liz is 9 spare, 9 spare, 9 spare, 9 spare, 9 spare, 9 spare, 6 times in a row, 9 spare for Liz Johnson after starting with the front 3. McEwen has managed to put an extra double on the board. So McEwen can still strike out for 259. Liz looking at a max of 224. But Danielle has an extra frame to bowl, of course. Danielle covers up the spare in the ninth. She still leads by 14. She can strike out for 238. Carbonetto looking for a double, and she gets it. Strike. First shot in the 10th. That will just about lock up the win for her this game. Just needs 7 pins on 2 shots. Carbonetto looks like she's going to pick up her first win of the day. McEwen, 237. Solid game for her. That'll push her to plus 67 for the game, which will move her to plus 700 overall. So good game for McEwen. That will help her cause here. And Jackie Carbonetto finally on the board with a victory here this morning. She gets the strike on the fill for 201. Closing out game seven, one game to go to wrap up our opening round of match play here this week. Once again, about 2.5 hours from the start of the final eight games of round robin match play. All right, so ready to get started with our last game here. Shannon Puhowski against Kelly Kulik, Missy Parkin against Diana Saviolo. This will be the last game of this round. Players will have a break while we re-oil and get started again at 1:30 p.m. Central Time this afternoon. An update for you on the standings. Rocio Restrepo is still in the lead, but just by a few pins. Rocio at plus 841, Shannon Puhowski at plus 837, Kayla Bandy plus 830, and Missy Parkin at plus 714. Fifth place is Danielle McEwen, who's only 14 pins back now. Stephanie Johnson is 55 pins back of fourth. Then it drops to Diana Zavialova, who's 107 pins back. Jody Westner, 120 back. Kelly Kulik, 128. Everybody else, more than 150 back. About fourth place. Still nine games to be added to those standings. Parkin with a double to start. She takes an early 11-pin lead on Diana. Kelly's got an early 10-pin lead on Puhowski. Pitched that one way right. Leaves the 1-2-4. Now Kelly Kulik. Third frame. Mm-hmm. Missy had the open, but Kelly makes her spare. Kelly leads by 9 against Pulhowski. And that open frame allows Diana to take the lead, sitting on the bench. Ring 10 for Kelly in the fourth. Looks like we've got a lane breakdown on 17. Big double for Diana. She takes it to a 14-pin advantage after 3.5 frames. Once again, Rocio Restrepo leading the way after 19 games total. That is one game left this game in this first round of match play. Rocio at plus 841. Shannon Pulhowski just 4 pins behind her at 837. Kayla Bandy just 11 pins off the lead at plus 830. Then it drops to Missy Parkin at plus 714. With Danielle McEwen 14 back of the show currently and Stephanie Johnson 55 back. Kelly trips out the 4 for the strike in the 5th. Leads by 8. Thank you. Diana working on a double, turns it into a triple, and the lead is growing. Now is up by 25. Kulhowski had a chance to take the lead with a strike there, but leaves the two pin. She goes high on that shot. Diana can push her lead to 35 with another strike here, looking for four in a row. Leaves the 10 pin. You can tell she didn't like it right away. Kelly working on a double, leading against Fulhowski, gets the strike. Kulik currently 128 pins outside of fourth, looking to make up some ground here in this final game of round one of match play. Double for Missy Parkin. She pulls to within 15. 3.5 to go. Strike for Diana in the seventh. Doesn't move the needle though, because she's working on a spare. She still leads by 14. Kulhowski has not doubled in this match, has not struck on this left lane. And still has not struck on this left lane. She leaves the 10 pin. It's going at a Dutch 200 pace. Getting steamrolled by Kelly Kulik right now. Kelly Kulick turns her four bagger into a five bagger going into the 10th. She can shoot 268 this game. Close out round one of match play. Missy Parkin, third consecutive strike. She inches closer. She's within four of Diana now and can take the lead with a strike on her next shot. Kelly has already locked up the win here in this game against Pluhowski, but trying to make up as much ground as she can. Currently 128 pins outside of fourth. Another good looking shot for Kulick. Missy Parkin for the lead. Oh, the six pin catches the bottom of the 10 for the strike. Double in the 10th for Kelly gets her to 260 territory this game. 268 with a strike on her fill ball. Diana trailing now for the first time in a while in this match. Diana can strike out for 238. Missy Parkin can shoot 244. Diana can double to force Missy to double. Trying to put the pressure on. Another strike for Diana. Puts her in the 230s. It's going to force Missy to double to win the game. And as we are down to our final frame of this opening round of match play here at the PWBA Minnesota Open. 264, 209. Kelly Kulik picks up the win. Kelly goes plus 94 this game. That will move her up to around plus 670 or so. And here is the final shot for Diana. This is the last match to finish up. She ends up at 237. So Missy Parkin is going to need a double in the 10th. Double and four to win this game. Missy gets it way right, gets six, and Diana is going to take the win to close out this first round. We will be back with you in about 2 hours with the start of round number two of match play here. All right, final shot as Diana Zavialova defeats Missy Parkin 237 to 219 to close out this opening round of match play. We'll be back with you in 2 hours here on Bowl TV on Extra Frame from Welch, Minnesota.